I welcome you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and Savior. You are listening to Reverend Mary YouTube channel. I want to share with you a word received from the Holy Spirit Monday, December the 5th, 2016. And I will also share with you the word received December the 4th, 2016. Monday's word says, arm yourselves for battle. Is this a time to remain unaware? Is this a time of peace? Is this a time of refreshing? No, arm yourselves for battle. No weapon formed against mine will prosper. Satan is rearing his head. He is out to devour you while he can. He will not stand against my power and might. No, he will not stand. He is the greatest deceiver of man. Prepare for battle. The war is being fought in heaven right now. My children, you must take a stand, a mighty stand. Do not silence your voices. Too many choices Satan has provided to keep this battle divided. My kingdom is strong. My children desire to do no wrong. You must stay in my holy word to arm yourselves in this battle. It is a war, a fight to the end. Yes, a bitter end. You go down swinging. You will be singing the new song that only my redeemed sing when they see their risen King. My children, this is no time for sitting idle. Pray on bent knees. Cry out to your heavenly Father. Not much longer, but things are to come that you must be stronger. Read and study to show thyself approved unto me, the Holy of Holies. Receive knowledge and wisdom from my holy word. You must seek and discern. You will see and learn new things. You will see things you've not seen before. This is war. The only way to be prepared is to stay in prayer and read my holy word. It is of vital importance that you spend time in my word. I will speak to you through my holy word. The Lord said, you are not to study, or you are not studying to find me. You are found of me, worthy already. But you are to immerse yourselves in my word, so that you are made strong to fight and receive my insight, my wisdom, my protection. Do you go to battle unarmed? No. Now arm yourselves. Arm yourselves with my holy word. Do not let a day or opportunity go by without reading or hearing my word. And then the Lord gave me two songs. You must fight to stand against all evil. And then he put in my spirit, Jesus set me free. Satan had me bound, but Jesus set me free. Don't be bound by Satan right now, brothers and sisters. I'm going to give you these scriptures, and then I'll put them in the description below. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 17, standing and seeing the salvation of the Lord. Ephesians chapter 6 and 12, battle against the spiritual forces of wickedness in heavenly places. Luke 22, 31 and 32. Simon, Simon, Satan has demanded permission to sift you like wheat. John chapter 16 and 33, in Jesus we have peace because he has overcome the world. Joshua 1 and 9, have I not commanded you be strong and courageous? Do not tremble or be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you. 1 Timothy chapter 6 and 12, fight the good fight of faith. Take hold of the eternal life to whom and where you were called, and you made the good confession in the presence of many witnesses. 1 Peter chapter 5, 9 and 10. But resist the devil, firm in your faith, knowing that the same experiences of sufferings are going on all over the world. After you have suffered a little while, the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself perfect, confirm, strengthen, and establish you. 1 Peter chapter 5, 8, the devil seeks someone to devour. Matthew 6 and 13, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Ephesians 6 and 11, put on the full armor of God so that you are able to stand firm against the schemes of the devil. Ephesians 6, 13 through 17, put on the full armor of God so that you will be able to stand, resist in the evil day. And having done everything to stand firm therefore, having girded your loins with truth and having put on the breastplate of righteousness and having shod your feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Take up the shield of faith, with which you will be able to extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And the new song scripture is Revelation 5 and 9. John 1:1 talks about the Word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. If you want to communicate with God in heaven, brothers and sisters, you are to immerse yourself in the Word. It is His holy Word. It will convict you of doing any wrong. It will strengthen your mortal body, brothers and sisters. It is healing in the power of Jesus' name. John 8:32, truth sets you free. The gospel is the truth, brothers and sisters. 2 Timothy 2:15, study to show thyself approved. And I'm going to give you the word from December 4, 2016. I woke up at 5:15 a.m. and the Spirit says, I will not compromise. People are taking God too lightly, a dangerous thing. If you love God, you search the Scriptures. His Word is written upon your heart. And once you are aware of a sin, you don't do it. No compromise. You are set apart. You no longer have the desire to serve self and Satan. We must fully obey God and His holy Word. Bottom line, compromising is forbidden. Some Bible verses that I had looked up for us is Galatians 1:6-7, Romans 13:14, 2 Corinthians 6:14-15, Matthew 6:24, and James 4:4. And then I thought of these two verses. Love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, soul, and mind. Love thy neighbor as you love yourself. And then Galatians 5:19-23 will preach. And then the Ten Commandments. Brothers and sisters, Jesus is coming, and He is saying, you have got to be worthy. Some of us, you are already worthy. He has made you worthy. We have called upon His name. We are not living in and of this world. But sinner, if you are listening to Reverend Mary right now, it is through the power and the unction of the Holy Spirit that your heart is being pricked right now, that you are being convicted, that you may even be shedding some tears right now. Jesus is coming back. Jesus is coming back, and He is a mighty King, and He will rule and He will reign, and you cannot have sin in your mortal body, brothers and sisters. You cannot have sin. Sin does not enter into the kingdom of God. Sin does not enter into the kingdom of God. God says He is not going to compromise. You are His and you are His fully. And brothers and sisters, if you are in your right standing with God right now, you are to gird yourselves up with His word. You are to pray like you have not prayed before. Pray on bent knee to Him. Shed tears. Pray for those that are lost and they are dying and going to a hell that is forever. It is eternity. Brothers and sisters, we are living in a lost and dying world. They need to wake up. God is going to allow some things to shake some people up. But brothers and sisters, saints, you are to pray. Because when you pray, oh, mighty God, Jesus has given a vision. When you pray, brothers and sisters, there is a cup in heaven. And your prayers, the prayers of the saints availeth much. The prayers of the saints availeth much, saith the Lord. That incense goes up to heaven. He hears our prayers. He hears the righteous pray. And He shows great mercy. He shows mercy to the lost. And that incense will flow out and cause mercy to be upon the lost. And brothers and sisters, if you have a lost loved one, as I do in my family, you have shared the gospel, you have shared Jesus Christ with them, but they are blinded by Satan's schemes. They are blinded. They do not see. Pray for mercy that their soul would be spared. Pray that they would call upon the name of Jesus in that hour. Pray, brothers and sisters. The Lord says that this is time to not go on like we have, that He is surely coming back, and it is going to be within the blink of an eye. We are here, and then we are gone. And the things that are coming after the church is raptured are not good. It is not good. You cannot even describe it, what is going to happen. But the Lord is warning His that if you have called upon His name, that sin does not enter and He is not compromising. We are too late in the ballgame to be compromising with God. You are to straighten up, go forth, be righteous and holy. He calls you to be righteous and holy. He calls you to be a voice before He comes back. He calls you to warn Warn the lost. Warn that he is coming. This is no time as any other. It is no time like any other in the whole time of history. Jesus is coming, brothers and sisters. Jesus is coming. Now, he has given two powerful words recently, and I got a feeling he's going to be pouring out his spirit even more, and you're going to hear prophets and handmaidens and servants start to speak under the unction of the Holy Spirit because his coming is so soon. And Father God, I just pray for everyone who has just listened to the words that you have given, Lord. Father, I pray that Satan, we bind you right now in the name of Jesus. You have no authority over any person. And brothers and sisters, right now, sinner, this is for you. The Lord says that you still have breath in your mortal body. You are to repent. You are to turn from your sin. You are to call upon his name right now. And you are to be right with him. That means to not go back into this world. You are not of this world, brothers and sisters. When you are born again, you are no longer of this world. Jesus has paid the price. There is nothing else. All we have to do is accept the gift. Somebody can give you a check for $100, but if you never go to the bank and you don't cash the check, it's not worth anything. Jesus Christ has already shed his blood on the cross for you and me, brothers and sisters. The price has been paid. It is just up to you to receive the eternal gift of salvation. And Father God, I just pray for everybody who hears this video that they repent, and it is not too late, Father. I pray mercy upon the soul of the sinner today, Lord Jesus. Father, I pray that you guide the steps and that you give boldness to those that need to be bolder, Lord, in you, that this is no time to be silent. Sound the alarm that Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. Mighty King, you are coming. And that is the way we're going to end this video. The Lord is going to give more words, and I thank him. I thank you, Lord Jesus, for the word that you have given, Father. I thank you for the encouragement, and I thank you that you talk to your children, and I thank you that you give us a mouth and you give us hands and feet to continue to be your mouthpiece, your hands and your feet before you return, Lord, because it will be a dark and an evil world without yours. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you.